Steve Dotto here. How the heck are you this fine day? Me, I'm feeling fantastic, and I'm glad you're joining me because I'm going to show you today three quick tips that you can do to troubleshoot issues that we're having on the internet. We all have days where the internet just isn't working the way it should. What do I do when I'm having one of those days? I'll tell you in just a few seconds. All right, we've all been there. We're trying to connect to a website which we know was there yesterday, and we are not connecting for whatever reason. We're having issues, and now we're all worried. Is the issue at my side? Is it a virus? Is it something in my router or in my Wi-Fi? Is it at their end? Are they having issues, or has something dastardly happened to the internet between us? What in the world is happening? How do we figure it out? Well, I just go through a very simple process if I'm having trouble connecting to the internet. The first is patience. Sometimes I just wait a little bit of time and try it again a little bit later. But if you're concerned that there's a problem with your internet connection, testing your speed, testing your upload and download speed is a great idea. And it's not only a great idea if you're having a problem, but it's also a great idea to make sure that you're getting what you're paying for from your ISP. So knowing what package and plan you have and what speeds you should be getting and then measuring it from time to time is a fairly healthy exercise. I use speedtest.net when I want to check it. Now, it's a free site. It's full of advertising. If you click on the wrong button, you're going to be taken into an ad like this Start Now ad that's just saying, please, please click on me. That one will actually take us into an ad. Where we want to begin is the begin test. And all it's going to do is it's going to go out onto through my internet connection, and it's going to test my upload speed, how fast I upload, and how fast I download from the internet. Now, actually, starting with download speed. So it's seeing how fast the internet can download data into my network here. This is very important for things like watching streaming video. So if you watch a lot of YouTube, if you watch Netflix a lot, you want to have really good download speed. And I actually pay for slightly upgraded service, so I want to make sure that I'm getting what I pay for. And it looks like I am. I'm getting close to 50 megabits per second downstream. That's pretty healthy. And my upstream connection, I also pay a little bit more for because I'm always uploading videos like this, so I want it to happen a little bit faster. And it looks like my upstream connection is working pretty well as well. Yeah, 7.91 megabits. That's right in the range of what I expect. So I know that my internet connection is fairly healthy. Now, if I'm still having issues, though, if I am having issues connecting to a website, the next thing I do if I know my internet connection is in good shape is I will try a different browser, or I will clear the cache of my existing browser just in case there's something in there, there's a cookie or something that's causing the website not to show properly or something along that line. It's not very often the case, but it's worth doing. It's especially worth doing if you're an Internet Explorer user. I'm sorry, but a lot of stuff just doesn't resolve well. Most of the problems that I have with people who are having trouble coming to my stuff, it's if they're using Internet Explorer. If they go to Firefox, or if they go to Chrome, or if they go to Safari, usually the problems solve themselves. So try a different browser or clear your browsing data if you're having issues. If you're still having issues, you might end up having to check technical support. And one thing that they're always going to ask you is, what's your IP address? Now, the average person just doesn't know what their IP address is, and there's no place you can look just on your screen here. But if you just start a new browser window and just type in, what's my IP? Now, the cool thing in Chrome is if I just type that in into the omnibar, which is the search bar, it's now called an omnibar, it's an intelligent search bar, it actually brings up what my IP address is so that I can share that with technical support immediately. If it doesn't show up because you're using a different browser for whatever reason, whatsmyip.org is the place that you can go, and you will quickly get your exact IP address that you can then share with technical support. Now, I'll include all of these links in the description field below or in the blog post if you're watching this on our website. But those are three steps that you can go through. It's not going to solve everything, but it gives you something to do to work your way through any issues and gets you on the path towards making sure your connection is in good shape. I hope you found this little tutorial today to be useful. If you have, there's three ways that you can stay in touch with us. The first way is you can subscribe to this channel, which will mean that you will get notification of each and every one of our videos as they come down the stream. Usually once a day during weekdays, we have a new video coming out. We also have a newsletter that we send out once a week, which includes a digest of all of our videos, plus information about any upcoming events that we might be doing, such as webinars that you might be interested in. And finally, the Dotto Tech channel is supported by the community that watches us through Patreon. Patreon is a crowdfunding site for content creators. If you haven't taken a look, please drop by our Patreon page, have a look, see what it's all about, and perhaps for as little as a dollar a month, you too can become one of our Patreon supporters. I appreciate you taking a look. And with that, I am done for the day. I'm Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.